The Haight-Ashbury Free Clinic.
A powerful and potentially dangerous stew is brewing in the Haight-Ashbury in 1967. Take one part rebellious spirits, two parts mind-altering drugs, and 100,000 parts young people flowing into the Haight with no access to medical care, which is how the Haight-Ashbury Free Clinic came into being. Founder, Dr. Dave Smith.
When I was in medical school, I was also in graduate school in pharmacology, studying psychopharmacology, the study of the effects of drugs on the mind. I did a postdoctoral fellowship in clinical toxicology, which is a study of diseases produced by drugs, and I was basically sticking LSD in white mice and doing drug research. But I'd walk home at night and just see this counterculture revolution start with the human being and Ken Kesey's electric acid Kool-Aid test. And I noted that when the kids were brought into the emergency room, they actually got worse. The doctors treated them harshly. There was law enforcement. And so the beginnings of the Haight-Ashbury Free Clinics for the hundreds of thousands of youth that came here, basically primary medical care and talking down bad LSD trips, there was a lot of prejudice and hostility towards anything having to do with drug treatment. They figured if they could deny them health care, they would go away.
The Haight-Ashbury Free Clinic opened with $100 of Dr. Smith's own money and $500 donated by a local Episcopal priest. The original office of 409 Clayton on the corner of Haight Street is still in operation. But the professional choices that Dr. Smith was making at the time were risky at best. He was treading into unknown waters.
I was getting a lot of criticism too. I remember when I first started the Haight-Ashbury Clinic, one of my professors of medicine said, "David, where did you go wrong? You're always such a promising young medical student." In other words, I was considered a bright laboratory scientist with a promising career that had gone astray by taking care of addicts on the street. And in a certain sense, the free clinic was a civil rights towards people that had drug problems. Right now, we accept addiction treatment. There was no addiction treatment in the 60s. You know, it was jail. Jail or death.
Without formal funding, the clinic barely had enough to operate, and that's when a certain rock and roll empresario got involved.
Bill Graham started organizing benefits for us, and he had Janis Joplin, Big Butter and the Holding Company, Grateful Dead, Jefferson Airplane, Carlos Santana, later Creedence Clearwater, and eventually George Harrison of the Beatles, all did benefits for us, but we definitely have our origins in rock and roll. Wouldn't have made it through the 60s without that support. And we've named one of our buildings after Bill Graham, who was really our patron saint, as the one that organized all of these benefits.
The clinic assisted more than just the hippie population. It was a haven for the poor and disenfranchised.
And then when the Vietnam vets started coming back, they would come back strung out on heroin, and they were so alienated from the government, they came to our clinic.
The Haight-Ashbury Free Clinic continues to operate today, based on a philosophy of inclusion and care for everyone.
Free in the free clinic is not just an economic term, it's a philosophical concept, and came out of that 60s movement where this whole city was considered a free city in the sense of being philosophically free. It also meant free of judgment. You know, in other words, we treated them in a non-judgmental way. We attempted to free them from the slavery of addiction. And one of the origins of that was Martin Luther King's speech, "Free at last, free at last, thank God Almighty, I'm free at last."
The 60s, with its ground zero being in the Haight-Ashbury, had a lasting and powerful effect on our culture. The clinic was there to make sure that the multitudes could survive such social upheaval.
When you got caught up in this counterculture revolution and you started taking care of the people, getting positive feedback, then you just saw a whole philosophical transformation occur, which happened to so many young people then. We still have people that talk about how their whole lives were changed by the 60s experience.
Today, the free clinic continues its mission of healthcare being a right, not a privilege.
We have 22 different sites throughout the Bay Area. We see 160,000 client visits a year. The original site is still at 558 Clayton Street, which has historic significance, and it's the first of now the nationwide free clinic movement. It was part of the origins of the developing field of addiction medicine.
If you find yourself on the corner of Clayton and Haight, feel free to drop a small donation off at the clinic's office, or visit them on the web at www.hafci.org.
haight-ashbury.org.